Good morning, children. I hope class 7 children are watching this video, and I hope you must be keeping well as we have been doing rational numbers. Already we have completed exercise 4B, and we had to start a new topic today, and that is addition of rational numbers. So today we are going to see addition of rational numbers. Those who have not completed exercise 4B, they must complete, because very soon your exam is going to be conducted, even PA1 and first term. So it is better together you try to learn. Practice in such a way, you must be very confident so that you should be able to appear in exam and you should be able to score good marks. So let's start our today's topic, and that is addition of rational numbers and some solved examples we will see. Here you have addition of rational numbers. Suppose we have to add two given rational numbers. First convert. What is needed to be done? First convert each of them into a rational number with a positive denominator. If any number has been given, and that is in negative, suppose you have 5 by minus 9. So what is required to be done? This is required to be converted into positive denominator, and for that what is needed to be done? By minus 1, this is required to be multiplied, so that you will get minus 5 by 9. In this way, first of all, we need to convert the rational number with a positive denominator. Case 1 has been given when denominators of given numbers are equal. If denominators are equal, then what is to be done? Let P by Q and R by Q be any two rational numbers. Then we define P by Q plus R by Q is equal to Q will be your LCM, and P plus R simply you need to do. So if denominator is equal, simply numerators are required to be added, that you remember. Thus, in order to add two rational numbers with the same denominator, we simply add their numerators and divide the sum by the common denominator. Example, you see, suppose you have 5 by 9 and minus 13 by 9. What is needed to be done? Simply the same rule will be required to be applied. Your common denominator is 9 and your numerator is required to be added. So 5 plus minus 13. So this will be 5 plus into minus minus, and this is 13, so divided by 9. So as you have studied in integer, what we do? If minus 13 and 5 you have, smaller number is required to be subtracted from the bigger number, sign will be negative, since bigger number what we have, that is with negative sign. So this will be minus 8 by 9. So in this way, this is required to be solved. Next, you see, you have 7 by minus 11 and 3 by 11. So what is needed to be done? This denominator is required to be converted into positive denominator. So 7 by minus 11 you have, that is required to be multiplied by minus 1. So you will get minus by 7 by 11. Now minus 7 by 11, and you need to add 3 by 11 with this. What is needed to be done? Common denominator you will write, and then both the numbers are required to be added. Minus 7 plus 3. So what you will get? Minus 7 and plus 3, minus 4 by 11. Just we need to subtract 3 from 7, and we need to see bigger number. Bigger number is 7, and that is with which sign? That is with negative sign. So answer will be in negative. So negative 4 or minus 4 by 11 we will write. Then you see, when denominators of given numbers are unequal, this method will be there for when your denominator is equal. And when your denominators are not equal, then what you need to do? Take the LCM of the denominators of the given rational numbers, express each of the given rational numbers with the above LCM as the common denominator. Now add the numbers as shown in case 1. Simply, denominator is required to be made equal, as you have learned how to write equivalent fraction or equivalent rational number. In that way, equivalent rational number is required to be written, and then you need to add numerator. Here you see example, you see you have minus 2 by 3 and 3 by 4. What has been done? LCM is required to be taken. So, LCM of 3 and 4 will be 12. Now, this minus 2 by 3 has been converted. Minus 2 by 3 is required to be converted with denominator. With denominator 12. So, what is required to be multiplied? 4. So, this will be minus 8 by 12 and second number you have 3 by 4. So, this will be 3 by 4 and that is equal to into 3. So, that you will get denominator 12. So, 9 by 12. Now, you have number minus 8 by 12 and 9 by 12. Same method we need to apply to what we have applied in case 1. Denominator is equal now. So, 12 minus 8 plus 9. So, this will be 1 by 12 and this will be your answer. So, in this way this is required to be solved. Just you see. Next you see 7 by minus 27 plus 11 by 18. Again this is required to be converted in positive denominator. So, it will be minus 7 by 27, just you see. Then this is required to be added and for that what you need to do? You need to find out LCM of 27 and 18. If you are finding out LCM of 27 and 18, what you will get? 3 into 3 into 3 into 2. So, 27 into 2, that is 54, that you have got. Now, both the rational number is required to be written as the denominator 54. So, equivalent fraction of minus 7 by 27 will be, here you see, minus 14 by 54 and 33 by 54. Two rational numbers you have got. Now, it is easy. Minus 14 by 54 plus 33 by 54. So, just you see, you have equal denominators, 54 you have written, here you have minus 14 and plus 33. This is required to be subtracted. Just you see, you subtract this, 13 minus 4 is equal to 9 and 2 minus 1 is equal to 1 and sign will be positive because bigger number you have 33 and that is positive. So, that is why 19 by 54 will be your answer. So, in this way this is required to be solved. Next example you see, add minus 3 by 8 and minus 5 by 12. The same thing has been done. 8 and 12, what you need to do? You need to find out LCM of this. So, this is 2 to j 4, 4 to j 8, 8 3 j 24 is your LCM. Now, minus 3 by 8 is required to be written as denominator 24. So, you will have minus 9 by 24 and second number you will have minus 10 by 24. Now, minus 9 by 24 plus minus 10 by 24 will become what? Your LCM will be, or equal denominator you have. So, your denominator will be 24 and here minus 9 and minus 10, it means minus 19 by 24 will be your answer. Next you see 9 by minus 16 and minus 5 by minus 12. Similar question is there. Here this is required to be converted first. 9 by minus 16 will be written as minus 9 by 16 and minus 5 by 12 can be written as minus 5 by minus 12 will be 5 by 12. So, your numbers are now minus 9 by 12 and 5 by 12, minus 9 by 16 and 5 by 12. So, 16 and 12 you have, you need to find out LCM of that. So, LCM you have got 48. Now, just equivalent fraction is required to be written of minus 9 by 16. So, that you have got minus 27 by 48 and the next number you have got 20 by 48. Now, this is required to be added. So, 48 you will write minus 27 plus 20. Just you see, bigger number is 27, 20 is required to be subtracted. What you will get? 7, sign will be negative because 27 is bigger number having negative sign. So, minus 7 by 48 will be your answer. Then you have find the sum of minus 5 by 9 plus minus 7 by 12 and plus 11 by 18. The same thing is required to be done. We need to find out the LCM of 9, 12 and 18. Three numbers are there, three rational numbers are there, even if more numbers will be there, 4, 5, 6 rational numbers will be there. Same method is required to be applied. All the denominators we will take and we will find out LCM of that. And then each and every rational numbers are required to be converted into the denominator having the LCM what you will get, and then we need to add. So, here you see this has been LCM has been found out, and that you have got 36. Now, minus 5 by 9 can be written as minus 20 by 36. Minus 7 by 12 has been written as minus 21 by 36, and 11 by 18 has been written as 22 by 36. Now, three numbers you have, minus 20 by 36, minus 21 by 36 and 22 by 36. These have been added. So, 36 we will write, and in numerator whatever numbers are there, they are required to be added. So, minus 20, minus 21 and 22. What we need to do, the numbers which are having minus sign are required to be added together. So, minus 20 and minus 21 has become minus 41. Positive number you have 22. So, minus 41 plus 22 we have written. Now, we need to subtract smaller number regardless of this sign, smaller number from bigger number. So, 41 minus 22 we will get 19, sign will be of bigger number, 41 you have, and carrying sign negative. So, your answer will be minus 19 by 36, this will be your answer. Next you see, express each of the following rational numbers as the sum of an integer and a rational number. 19 by 6 you have. So, this can be written as just you divide this, you will get 3 whole 1 by 6, or this can be written as 3 plus 1 by 6. So, here as 19 by 6, we can write 3 whole 1 by 6, 6 3 is 18 and 1 19 by 6. This can be written as 3 plus 1 by 6. So, this is integer, this is rational number. Minus 22 by 5, the same thing has been done, minus has been taken out, has been divided, you have got minus 4 whole 2 by 5. So, this can be written as minus 4 plus minus 2 by 5, this is required to be understood. Here you see, minus 4 whole 2 by 5 you have, this can be written as minus 4 plus 2 by 5. Now, you see minus is there, when bracket will be opened, then minus sign will be with both term 4 and 2 by 5. So, here you will have minus 4 plus minus 2 by 5, in this way we need to write. So, this you try to understand. Next you see, you have example 9, Rahul walks 2 by 3 kilometer from a place P towards east, and then from there 1 whole 5 by 6 kilometer towards west. What is its position now from P? Just you see, Rahul walks 2 by 3 kilometer from a place P towards east. Suppose Rahul was here at P point, and then he walks towards east. Towards east, how much? 2 by 3 kilometer. And then from there, 1 whole 5 by 6 kilometer towards west. From here, he returned back. And how much he came? 1 whole 5 by 6 kilometer. What is his position now from P? From P, where is he now? We need to find out. Let us denote the distance covered towards east by positive sign, then the distance covered towards west would be negative sign. If we are considering towards east positive, so towards left it will be negative, or towards west it will be negative. Rahul's final distance from P will be what? 2/3 plus minus 1/5/6, because in west direction he came back. So sign will be negative. So 2/3 plus minus 11/6, it will become 6 × 1 = 6 and 5 × 11/6. So finally you will get your, again you can convert this into, as it was explained before in other example, like that we can write. Suppose you have 2/3 and minus 11/6. What we need to do, we need to find out LCM. So LCM of 3 and 6 will be 6. Now this is required to be converted, 2/3 into what we will multiply, so that we will get denominator 6, by 2 we need to multiply. So 2 × 4/6. So this you have 4/6 and this is minus 11/6. So LCM will be 6, and here it became 4/6. So this will be 4 plus minus 11/6. Now you see 4 plus minus 11, it means what? Minus 7/6, and that will be minus 1/6 kilometer. It means minus sign is showing from P he is west side. In east side we had assumed positive, so he is in west side. How far? Minus 1/6 kilometer. So Rahul is at a distance of 1/6 kilometer from P towards west. We will write answer. So in this way this is required to be solved. So today we have understood how to add rational numbers. So two cases we have seen, when denominators are equal, and the other case is when denominators are not equal. When denominators are equal, that is so easy, only denominators is required to be written. Suppose P by Q plus R by Q, you have equal denominator is required to be written, and numerator are required to be added, and it is required to be divided. So in this way we need to solve. When denominators are unequal, then what we need to do? We need to find out LCM of denominators. Different denominators you have, unequal denominators you have, that we need to find out LCM of that. And then we need to find out equivalent fractions having denominators, what LCM we are getting of each and every rational number. And then in case one, what method we have applied, the same method is required to be applied, and we need to find out the sum. So in this way we have completed addition of rational number. I hope you have understood. Go through in proper way all the example again, and then you start exercise 4C. I hope you will be able to do. Otherwise we will see in next class, and till then thank you.